This session is on writing methods. Before we understand how to write methods, let's talk about why we need methods with an analogy. So let's say the managing director of a company wants to prepare an annual report. So for that, he basically needs details from other departments. So he may be asking the details from marketing department. To put in his annual report, he needs to know the marketing and sales information. He also needs the finance information, and he also needs the HR information, how many employees are there in the company. So basically, in order to get all this information and put it in his annual report, it is not something he goes and prepares the marketing and sales information report. He does not prepare the finance report. He does not prepare the HR information report. But instead, he will be reaching out to the folks and asking them to get the report. So what it will be shared to them is, he will be just sharing the input details. Hey, I need the marketing and sales information for the year 2020. So all that he shares is just the input. And what he's expecting is the report that will be coming from the marketing and the sales department. So how the marketing and sales department is going to prepare the report is their burden, actually. They are going to take care of how they are going to prepare the report. All that they need is the certain input parameters. Once you provide that certain input parameters, that department knows how to prepare that report and send it back to whoever needs that report. So this is a typical thing which will happen. The managing director alone will not prepare all the reports, but he gets the information from various departments by contacting them, supplying some input parameters and getting the output from them, and collating that information into his final report and preparing the annual report. So methods is a very similar concept in Java. So methods is nothing but is a block of code which only runs when it is called. So in our analogy, let's say the marketing department knows how to prepare a report, but they will not just like the prepare a report. They'll be preparing the report only when somebody is asking them to do it, actually. So that is what the methods here is also going to do. They are not going to automatically get invoked, but it will be invoked only when some other code is calling them. So it is basically a block of code which does some operation, and it will be getting called by some other code. So as you know, methods is doing some actions which will solve some problem or which is doing some actions. Methods can take some input data and return some input data. So return some output data to the caller of the function. I'll be interchangeably using this method and function, but they mean the same here. So, and then methods provide reusability of the code. How you are getting reusability? Let's say today the managing director is asking for the report from the finance department. So they are able to provide the report. Tomorrow there may be another person, the finance head may be asking the same report. So they are going to do the same thing and going to give the report for him. So they do the same work. So we are kind of reusing their effort here. The same function we are trying to call from multiple places, and we are able to get the report out of it. By doing methods, it is going to be more maintainable. If you are not writing methods, there will be a lot of duplication of code. Here, again, going back to the analogy, like if at all, think about a finance head is, finance head needs a finance information. If he himself is doing this, he is going to go to that, department, get the details, and he's going to prepare a report. The same is going to be done by the managing director when he wants to prepare an annual report. So it is a duplication of work done by both these persons. Instead of that, if that is maintained in a separate method, all that they need to do is they need to call that and then get the information done from them. Okay, let's see this in a Java program, how it can be done in a Java program. Just as whatever we saw as an analogy, let's try to implement them using the methods basically. So as my job is to do basically a annual report for 2020. So from main method is the one which is going to get invoked first, as you know. So the main method is in turn calling another method. The method name is prepare annual report. and then it is passing the actual value 2020 for the year 2020. So if you see, this is the role of the managing director who wants to prepare this annual report. So the report name, I mean the method name is prepare annual report. It takes one argument, input argument, which is a very similar thing like a variable. We call this as a parameter variable. So we are passing a parameter called year. We are passing 2020 is the actual value, which is going to be passed as a year parameter to this method. So year will be receiving 2020. The prepare annual report is the method name, which is going to work for this input argument, which is 2020. And you would have seen something like a void there. What is void means I am not returning anything. I don't want to give any output basically to the calling method. That is what it is called as void. So sometimes you will be returning value. Sometimes you will be just accepting values. Sometimes you will be accepting values as well as returning the values. Okay. So let's take another example. Like if you wanted to, you are calling a person in your company to get some cash from bank. So you are giving him a check basically with let's say $5,000, and what do you expect from him is $5,000 in cash. So you call that person, you know, give him the check, and then ask him to withdraw the money and get you the cash. So here the input you are giving to the person is nothing but the check. The output you are expecting from the person is the $5,000 in cash. So you don't care about how this person goes to the bank and get the cash for you. So he may come in through a car, he may come in through a public transport. So he doesn't care how he goes there, whom he talks with, how he fills up the forms to get that the money, whom he interacts with the bank. All this information, you don't need it actually. He will be taking care of it. So that is what we are trying to do in the methods. So I am just giving that whatever he needs to do I'm leaving it to him. I don't care about it. All that I'm concerned is, hey, this is the input and this is the output I'm expecting. Okay. And I don't really care about how he wants to perform the job. I just work with what he needs as input and what he's supposed to give me as the output. I just care about that. From his point of view, what he cares about is whether you are giving the right input to him, whether you are giving the check to him, and he knows what he needs to return to him. So that is what he is concerned about. So that's where your methods comes into picture. So here, if you see the program, like first he is getting the sales information. How he gets the sales information? By calling a method called getSalesInfo, and he is passing the year. Year, as you know, it is already getting 2020 from the caller. So it is going to pass 2020 to the getSalesInfo method, and it is going to get a sales number from that method. The same thing happens with the financial information. It is going to call the getFinancialInfo is the method name. Here is the argument we are passing. GetEmployeeTotalCount is the method name, and you are going to pass the year as the argument, and you are going to get back as an integer as the result actually. Finally, when the MD gets all this report, he's just collating that information and printing that in a providing annual report containing those information. That's what we see in the system.out.println. So as you see the method names here, get employee total count, which is returning an integer, and this will have the logic to calculate what is the employee count for 2020. Here I have just hard coded 570, that is the employee count I have hard coded it. But as you see, there's a return statement, which is a branching statement, where it is going to return this value to the calling function. Whenever you see return, that is the time, you know, it performs all the calculations, is done, and then finally it is returning the value to the calling function. So whatever value it is returning should match with whatever the calling method is expecting. Basically, it has to match with the signature. Here in the signature, what we say here, get employee total count is going to return an integer. If you see just before the get employee total count, it specifies the return time. So it is expected to return an integer. So we are supposed to return an integer, and it will be accepting an integer argument, which is the year argument. When you see the calling place of it, it is called an int count is equal to get employee total count of year. So get total employee count is the method name. Year is the input argument, which is going to be 2020. which is and then the which is it, it is going to, once you call this method, the method is executing and performs all the operation. Finally, it returns some value, and that value is getting stored in the count actually. The same thing happens with the get finance information method, which is returning a string argument, and another method, get sales info method, which is taking the year argument and returning the double value. So here I have hard coded like return 50,000, you know, 500,000, return finance information, all these things. But in reality, you know, you will be returning the actual values. For that to return, they will perform a lot of operations to get it returned actually. This is just a you know, demonstration of the example, whatever we have, you know, undergone. So here this 2020 and then this year, what you are passing, these are called as the actual values. The actual values you are passing to the methods. And this int year, wherever you are, you know, these are the method names, prepare annual report, get employee total count, get financial information, get sales information, all these are method names. And this year is whatever you are passing inside the method. This is called as the input parameters, or you can call it as the input arguments. And this, what is getting returned is nothing but the return type. Okay, so let's try to do it in the same thing in the Eclipse. Not this program, maybe a different one, we'll try. So we have already done some student program, as you know. So we collected 3 marks from the student, and then we have like, we calculated the result here, and we calculated, if the result is passed, we calculated the grade for the student. So I'm good with one student. Here I received the marks for one student. I'm good with that. What if I have to do for another student? The same thing, I want to do it for another set of 3 marks actually, or I want to repeat this for another student. How would I do this? What I have to do, I have to repeat all this code, right? I need to copy this M1, M2. So let's say if I want to do it at the same time, the one way is we can just change these numbers and we can run this program, that is fine. But I wanted to basically I don't want to change the numbers and run the program, but I wanted to see the results of 2 students here. I don't want to see the results of 1 student. I want to see the result of 2 students at the same time. So how would I do that? So for that, the methods are going to help me. So one way to do it is, you know, without the methods, what you have to do is we need to basically copy the whole code again. And then we are going to you know, just change the marks. So the first one will execute for the first marks, and the second one will execute for the second marks. Let's say second marks is going to be 76, 67, and then let's say 47. So this is already, we have declared this, so I'm going to, you know, remove these things. So because M1, M2, M3 is already declared, string result is already declared, so I'm just going to remove this. String grade is also already declared, so I'm just removing the data type. So now when you run this program, this is going to work. So it is going to perform the this is the student calculation for the grade calculation for the first student. This is going to be the grade calculation for the second student. So it still works, but if I want to do it for more than 2 students, again you have to repeat the whole thing. That is fine. But what if there is not only this, what if I change basically the logic? Let's say I say if the student is, you know, considered as pass only if he gets, you know, more than 4, I mean, the pass mark is not 35, I want to update it to 45. So if I do it for 2 students, I need to go ahead and change all the places here in for the first student as well as for the second student. So that is going to be an overhead for us, right? So I don't really need to do this way if I write methods. So if I make it as a method for which performs the student grade calculation, I don't need to do it again and again for each of the students for different inputs. So if you see in these two statements, in these 2 blocks, all that I'm changing is the marks. Mark 1, mark 2, mark 3 is alone changing. All the other logic is going to remain the same. It is not even changing. They are the same logic. If you see here as well as here, they are the same logic. So better to write a method out of it. So how do you write a method? Let's do that. I'm going to remove this. So this is our logic. So I'm going to make this as a method. So let's see how to make this as a method. I'm going to write public static. We'll talk about what is public static in the later sessions. Now what I have to do is public static and then name the method, give a name for the method. Before giving the name of the method, we need to know what is the method is going to return. So I'm saying the method is not going to return anything. It is just going to print the student information. So I'm just giving it as void here. And then here I'm going to give like get student, or not even get, I would say print student grades. And now I need to pass, for printing the student grades, I need to pass three marks here, right? So I want to pass integer m1, integer m2, and integer m3. So I'm passing three marks here. After I pass three marks, I just going to copy all the logic, whatever we have done here to calculate the result and the marks from here. I'm just going to cut this and put it into this method. So now we have isolated and bring the logic of printing the student grades into a different method, right? So now we this method is not going to work as it is, right? We need to call this method. Somebody has to call this method. The only method that is getting called from when you run the program is the main method. So main method has to invoke this method. So how it is going to invoke this method is we can simply call with the method name. So just call the method name with the marks. So I'm going to give the marks as 76, 75, 45. These are the three marks I am passing. What will happen here? 76, this method will be called, and it is going to pass the input arguments, which is 76 will be substituted for M1, 65 will be substituted for M2, and 45 will be substituted for M3. And this logic, this sequence of operations is going to get performed for this input, whatever you have given here. So if I wanted to repeat the same thing for a different input, all that I need to do is just copy this and call the method again for a different argument. Let's say I'm going to call it for a different argument. So I can repeat this calling of this method for many number of students here. So I don't need to repeat the whole logic again as we did before, because it is going to execute the same logic. All that is going to be different is the mark what he is getting. The logic or whatever we are doing to calculate the student grade is not going to change for any of these students. So the advantage in this thing is, you know, if I have to change any logic here, like a grade calculation logic, if I want to change, or let's say we want to change the pass mark to 35 to 40, it is done only for in this method. You don't need to do it in your main method and update all your code. So that is also going to be much easier. So as we saw in this method, you know, this method is not going to be called, you know, it's not going to be invoked by on its own. Somebody has to call this method. Second thing is, you know, this provides you reusability of the code. That means I can call this method many number of times with different marks. So it is providing the reusability of the code. And this code is more maintainable. So if I want to change anything, I can just go ahead and change in that particular place instead of, you know, changing in multiple places. Since I did not duplicate the code, it is more maintainable. So let's run this program. Yeah, as you see here, the first this for the first student and this for the second student. Since the second student is not having, you know, he's a failed candidate, he does not have the percentage printed here. So if you wanted to give in a more printable way, you can always, you know, have the student name passed. You can also pass the student name, so that makes it very clear which student is getting this mark, right? So you can simply pass the name of the student. So let's say I'm passing the name of the student, and here also I'm passing the name of the student. So Raj is the name of the first student, Ram is the name of the second student. So when you pass something, it has to receive that argument, right? So we are passing a string here. So I'm getting the name. Once you get the name here, all that time, I can print the name. So before printing the result, I can print out the name of the student. And I can print the result, whether he's passed or failed, and also I can print the grade. And once I print the grade, I can always, you know, introduce a let's say dash dash dash, so that I know that the student record has completed printing. Go ahead and run this program now. Now you see the name of the student, and then the result of the student, percentage of the student, and the grade of the student. And the percentage will not be printed if the result is failed, actually.